Hi, I'm Rick Emerson, and welcome back to Outlook Portland on Northwest 32 TV. We're here with Mr. Donald Tyler and Mr. Wyatt Woods of Holy Kakow, organic chocolate sauce, syrup. I keep saying sauce, but it's wrong. You guys have got
syrups and powders.
More than, what products do you have? Tell me about the whole line.
Go ahead.
We have two different cocoa powders, or cacao powders, however you want to pronounce it. One is more for baking, organic, single origin out of Peru. And the other cocoa powder we have is a raw cacao powder. If you want health in chocolate, that's it. It's been cold pressed. It maintains a lot more of a higher nutrient value. And we have our Rapture chocolate syrup, which you can pretty well put on anything. It's a food, so it's not exclusive to ice cream. It's not something that you just make hot chocolate with, but you should. But I like to make a peanut butter chocolate banana sandwich.
Oh, see, why do you got to do that? Why is trying to concentrate?
Right.
You just got to tell me it's a food, like I can just eat it out of the thing with a spoon, which I will be doing later.
Sure.
You guys have got, it's a niche, but with a niche, and we were talking to Stacy and Rob about this regarding Secret Aardvark, that people get very attached to something. I mean, people have got their type of hot sauce, they've got their brand of coffee, they've got a type of cheese or a type of wine, and chocolate's the same thing. And Portland is especially a bit of a mix of blue-collar sensibilities and snobbishness, sort of, you know, they're all intertwined. How much more difficult does that make it to market a product like this?
We don't really see our product as a niche product. We see our product as something that is going to purvey, a new type in the category. So you don't have to look at, like, a really poor-tasting, poor-textured organic chocolate syrup or another chocolate syrup that's basically has 16 different types of corn sweetener in it, which are every variety is horrible for you. We basically wanted something that tasted great on both ends of the spectrum, had a great texture, had a great, you know, consistency, and was healthy, that basically brought all of the best ideas of sustainability, very small carbon footprint of how we source everything, and put all that stuff together in something that you can put in and on everything.
It really, and I have to tell you this, I don't have much of a sweet tooth. I'm sort of a casual fan of chocolates or whatever, but I knew we were gonna be talking about this, and my wife is a fan of this product anyway, and so I didn't remember what it was. I had some coconut ice cream or something sitting around the house, and I just squeezed some on. And I did that Homer Simpson thing of speaking around the, you know, this is the best thing I've ever had. And it was really just unbelievable.
Right.
And it sounds like such a, and I'm not saying that as some, you know, as a, I'm not on the take, as they say. But it really is incredible. And it makes you wonder if you could just get everybody in the country in a room and give them things like this that are made from actual real ingredients, if we would all kind of take a vote as a society and decide to, you know, to ingest more things like this.
Well, we're hoping that people will take a vote and then just kind of push all of the other alternatives off the shelf because, we're trying to speak to all types of audiences where you're buying, whether you're buying the cheap chocolate and this just simply tastes better. And
well,
that's all you care about is taste.
If the vote doesn't work, there's always the threat of violence. Don't rule that out.
Yeah, maybe the angel wings will become the angel of death.
Yeah.
Tell me about the illustration on the front. There's, I don't want to call it disturbing, but it's disturbing.
Which one? Yeah, because
on the
there's
on
an ugly dude on one of them. And
a winged man who's.
Yeah. Well, both are winged men. One's doing kind of the northwest.
Please tell me where that came from.
Well, Donald and I were just out riding our bikes around one day here in Portland, as we do, and Donald's pretty nifty with a camera.
And I told him to get naked in front of a building,
Is it that easy, really?
It was in front of a large bank building, and I had to do it quickly because I heard the buzzer and security being called. And so Donald took a few pictures and
shirtless. Pants were coming off, but.
Here's the thing, you've given me all these details, and yet I somehow feel as though I am no closer to actually understanding the story. Well done, I like your obfuscating style. For people out there that have got an idea for their own kind of product, their own kind of food, and we touched on this earlier, what is the hardest part that you didn't anticipate? What is the most difficult step that you didn't see coming?
Patience.
Yeah.
In terms of in all parts of the process?
Absolutely, it's just patience. You have to be just infinitely patient with every step of it, and right now it's basically with the sales process because basically we're behind kind of the logistics of other companies and how they actually adopt the product, and it takes a while. So even from a coffee shop to, you know, a bigger corporate enterprise, basically it's all around the same decision making time. So it's basically us being patient and, you know, keeping everything in line so we are financially stable so we can actually wait for them to pull the trigger and start using our product.
Holy Kakow organic chocolate, Donald Wyatt. We will have you guys back again at some point, if only
Thank
so
you.
I can
Thanks.
Fill my gullet full of more of this miraculous product. Thank you for watching Outlook Portland. My name is Rick Emerson. If you find me even moderately amusing, you can learn more about me at rickemerson.com. You can send us a show or guest suggestion at outlookportland.com. Until next time, insert trademark catchphrase here. We will see you next Sunday right here on Outlook Portland on Northwest 32 TV.
No, I didn't feel like this.
No, it was great. We got to almost, you know, I think we got to about a third of the question. I'm going to shoot this out of order, so I'm going to do my intro here for the whole show.